Good morning, students. Welcome to Samagra Siksha Andhra Pradesh online classes. How are you, students? My name is P. Vengatratnamma, CRT in Biology, working in KGBV Vengatagiri, SPSR, Nellore District. Students, today we will discuss about 10th class biology, 4th lesson, excretion. Students, in previous class, we discussed about excretion in human beings. Students, did all read the lesson and complete assignments? Okay, students, let us recall what we are discussed in before classes. These are topics: anabolism, catabolism, metabolism, external structure of the kidney, internal structure of the kidney, mechanism of urine formation, structure of nephron, dialysis, kidney transplantation, and organ donation. Students, in this session, we will discuss about other pathways of excretion, excretion in other organisms, excretion and release of substance in plants, excretion versus secretion. Students, what is the excretion? The definition of excretion. Excretion is the process of removing wastes and excess water from the body. It is an essential process in all living things. It is one of the major ways the human body maintains homeostasis. Excretion also prevents damage to the body. Wastes include by products of metabolism, some of which are toxic and other non-useful materials, such as used up and broken down components. Some of the specific waste products that must be excreted from the body include carbon dioxide from cellular respiration, ammonia and urea from protein catabolism, and uric acid from nucleic acid catabolism. Now discuss about other pathways of excretion. We know the main excretory system in our body are kidneys. Without this excretory system, our body will be like or thus being full of nitrogenous waste, but other than kidney. We have other than type of excretory organs also. These excretory organs are called as accessory excretory organs. Excretory organs are two types. The first one is main excretory organs. The second one is accessory excretory organs. Students, the example of main excretory organs, kidneys. Kidneys, we have discussed about in previous classes. Excretory organs, the example of lungs, skin, liver, large intestine. Organs of excretion include the skin, liver, large intestine, lungs, and kidneys. Together, these organs make up the excretory system. They all excrete wastes, but they do not work together in the same way that organs do in most other body systems. Each of the excretory organs does its own thing more or less independently of the others. But all are necessary to successfully excrete the full range of wastes from the human body. The first one is skin. We know the main function of this skin is protection, but other than protection, skin also works as a accessory excretory organ. Skin of mammals is glandular, contains two main glands. Two glands are present in our skin. First one, sebaceous gland. Second one is sudoriparous gland. Students, we can see this picture. This is our skin. Two glands are present in our skin. First one, sebaceous gland. Second one, sudoriparous gland. Now discuss about sebaceous gland. The function of the sebaceous gland is to produce sweat in the skin. Children, see this picture. This is sebaceous gland. The function of the sebaceous gland is to produce sweat in the skin. This gland separates waste from the blood and throw them out in the form of sweat. They are called simple vascular and tubular glands. Students, sebaceous gland, coiled, simple vascular and tubular glands. The next gland, sweat is mainly formed of water, inorganic salts, lactic acids, some urea and carbon dioxide. The main role of sweat production is to cool the body and maintain temperature homeostasis. The next gland is sudoriferous gland. It is a oil gland, produces oil called as sebum. Children, see this picture. This is sudoriferous gland. It is oil gland, produces oil called as sebum. This oil is made of lipid, sterols, hydrocarbons, and fatty acids. This provides a protective layer over the skin, open in hair fall follicle. The next one is lungs as an excretory organ. The main function of the lung is to remove carbon dioxide and some water vapor from the body during the expiration phase of respiration. Lung expels around 18 liters of carbon dioxide and about 400 ml of water per day from the body. The next one is liver as an excretory organ. The main function of liver in excretion, formation of bile and urine pigments from the hemoglobin of dead red blood cells. Children, see this picture. This is liver. Deamination and detoxification of amino acid and converts into urea through ornithine cycle. Deamination and detoxification of amino acid and converts into urea through ornithine cycle. Excretes cholesterol, inactivation products of steroid hormones, certain vitamins and many toxic drugs. Students, liver is also involved in urea formation. Liver is also involved in urea formation. The next one is large intestine as an excretory organ. The main function of large intestine in excretion. The epithelial cells of colon remove certain salts like calcium phosphate from the blood and remove it through feces. Children, see this picture. This is large intestine colon. The epithelial cells of colon, these epithelial cells. This is epithelial cells. The epithelial cells of colon remove certain salts like calcium phosphate from the blood and remove it through feces. Students, small amount of nitrogenous wastes are also eliminated through saliva and tears. Now discuss about excretion in other organisms. Different organisms are used to varied strategies in excretion. Excretory organs are absent in unicellular organisms. The example of unicellular organisms, amoeba and paramecium. Students, excretory organs are absent in unicellular organisms. The example of unicellular organisms, amoeba and paramecium. These organisms remove waste products by simple diffusion from the body surface into the surrounding water. These organisms remove waste products by simple diffusion from the body surface into the surrounding water. Freshwater organisms like amoeba, paramecium, possess osmoregulatory organelle called contractile vacuole. Multicellular organisms possess different excretory organs for removal of waste materials from the body. Structural and functional complexity of excretory organs from sponges to humans. Students, structural and functional complexity of excretory organs from sponges to humans. Sponges and cylindrates do not have specific excretory organs as water baths almost all their cells. Students, sponges and cylindrates do not have specific excretory organs as water baths almost all their cells. Excretory structures appears for the first time in flatworms are known as phloem cells. Students, excretory structures appear for the first time in flatworms are known as phloem cells. The first phylum is protozoa. The example of protozoa organisms, amoeba and paramecium. Excretory system in phylum protozoa, simple diffusion from the body surface into the surrounding water. Children, see this picture. This is amoeba, the example of protozoa. This is paramecium, the example of protozoa. Usually, they excrete the waste materials by a simple diffusion process within the cytoplasm of amoeba. Within the cytoplasm of amoeba. Respiration happens and oxygen has been consumed and carbon dioxide has been formed in the cytoplasm and the carbon dioxide out by simple diffusion process. The next phylum, porifera and cylindrata. The example of porifera organisms, sponges, the example of cylindrata organisms, hydra. Excretory system in phylum, porifera and cylindrata. Water baths almost all their cells and the excretory materials from the cells freely diffuse into the water and can be removed. Children, see this picture. This is sponges, this is hydra. Sponges, the example of porifera, hydra, the example of cylindrata. Sponges pours all over the body. Through pores, water enters into the body. And there is a pore is called osculum. Through the water, flowing will be out. The next phylum is platyhelminthes. The example of platyhelminthes organism, planaria. Excretory system in phylum, platyhelminthes, phloem cells. The phloem cells is a specialized excretory cell found in the simplest freshwater invertebrates, including flatworms and roundworms. Tube-like structure is called photonephridia. Tube-like structures is called photonephridia. These waste will be collected by phloem cell and pushed into the tube cell and out to the body. The next one is nematoda. The example of nematihelminthes, roundworms. Excretory system in phylum nematoda, Renetti cells. Nematodes possess a glandular system composed of Renetti cells unique to the roundworm. Children, see this picture. This is roundworm. This is excretory pore, water through the excretory pore. The next phylum is Annelida. The example of Annelida phylum organism, earthworm. Excretory system in phylum Annelida. The nephridium is an invertebrate organ found in pairs and performing a function similar to the vertebrate kidney. The earthworm, the body is in the form of segments. Nephrostome collect the waste and process into the out of the nephridiopore. The next one is arthropoda. Two types of excretory organs in arthropoda. the phylum of arthropoda, the example of organism cockroaches. Excretory system in phylum arthropoda, two types, green glands and malpighian tubules. Green glands present in the crustaceans, malpighian tubules present in the arthropods. Green glands are excretory organs of some arthropods like crustaceans on either side of the head. Malpighian tubules. Malpighian tubules are slender tubes, normally in the posterior region of arthropods, alimentary canals. The next one is mollusca. The example of mollusca organism, snails. Excretory system in phylum mollusca, Metanephridia. The Metanephria are organized together to form small kidney. The Metanephridia are organized together to form small kidney. The next one is Echinodermata. The example of Echinodermata organism, starfish. Echino means spine. Derma means skin. Excretory system in phylum Echinodermata, water vascular system. Echinodermata to form tube-like structures present through which water enters into the animal and comes out of the animal. The next one is reptiles, boats and mammals. The example of excretory organs, kidneys. Students, we have already discussed about in previous class kidneys. Students, excretory organs, kidneys in our body. The waste materials removed through the kidneys in our body. Now discuss about excretion in plants. Excretion and release of substance in plants. Plants does not have specific organs to excrete these wastes. Plants break down wastes at much lower rate than the animals. All the plants utilize some of the waste substances in some other process. Example, oxygen used for respiration. Carbon dioxide is used in photosynthesis. The excess amount of carbon dioxide and oxygen are released out into the atmosphere through the stomata. The excess amount of carbon dioxide and oxygen are released out into the atmosphere through the stomata. Excess gases are sent out through the stomata. The plants can get rid of excess water by a process like transpiration and guttation. The plants can get rid of excess water by a process like transpiration and guttation. Students, this is stomata. See this picture, this is stomata. There is another interesting fact. Waste products are stored in leaves, bark, and fruits. When these dead leaves, bark, and ripened fruits fall off, some of the wastes are stored in the fruits in the form of solid bodies is called rafts. Some of the wastes are stored in the fruits in the form of solid bodies is called rafts. However, several compounds are synthesized by the plants for this own use, especially for defense. Many plants synthesize chemicals and store them in roots, leaves, and seeds, etc. Some of the plants release attractants for other organisms, which will help the plants for pollination, seed dispersal, or even in their nutrition. For example, plants having root nodules secrete chemicals to attract into the surroundings of the roots and from a symbiotic relationship with rhizobium. These compounds are called secondary metabolites. The biochemical substances produced in plants are two types. The first one is primary metabolites. The second one is secondary metabolites. The metabolites like carbohydrates, fats, and proteins are primary metabolites. The example of primary metabolites are carbohydrates, fats, and proteins are primary metabolites. Secondary metabolites, the materials which do not require for normal growth and development are secondary metabolites. The materials which do not require for normal growth and development are secondary metabolites. The example of secondary metabolites are alkaloids, tannins, resins, gums, and latex. The differences between secondary metabolites and primary metabolites. This one primary metabolites, this one secondary metabolites. Metabolites which are directly involved in body's basic metabolic reactions like normal growth, development, reproduction, etc. Organic compounds synthesized by plants and microbes not as essential part of metabolic pathway but as side products. They have definite role and function in metabolism and are essential for growth and development. Not directly involved in growth and development, play role in ecological functions like defense, medicinal use, flowering, etc. They can also be poisonous sometimes. The example of primary metabolites, alcohol, amino acids, nucleic acids, vitamins, etc. The example of secondary metabolites, pigments like anthocyanin, alkaloids like morphine, toxins, antibiotics, drugs like polymeric substances like rubber and gums. Now discuss about alkaloids. These are nitrogenous byproducts and poisonous. These are stored in different parts of the plants. Common alkaloids in plants and their uses are given below. The first one is quinine. It is obtained from bark of Cinchona officinalis. That is Cinchona plant. It is used as anti-malarial drug. The next one is nicotine. It is obtained from leaves of Nicotiana tabacum, that is tobacco plant. It is used as insecticide stimulant. Next one is morphine and cocaine. It is obtained from fruit of Papaver somniferum, that is opium plant. It is used as painkiller. The next one is reserpine. It is obtained from root of, that is Rauvolfia serpentina. This plant snake root. It is used as medicine for snake bite high BP. The next one is caffeine. It is obtained from seed of Caffia arabica, that is Caffia plant. It is used as central nervous system stimulant. The next one is nimbin. It is obtained from seeds, barks, leaves of Azadi recta indica, that is neem plant. It is used as antiseptic. The second one is scopolamine. It is obtained from fruits, flower, that of Datura stramonium, that is Datura plant. It is used as sedative. The last one is pyrethroids. It is obtained from flower of chrysanthemum plant. It is used as insecticides. The next one is tannins. Tannins are carbon compounds. These are stored in different parts of the plant and are deep brown in color. Tannins are used in tanning of leather and in medicines. The example of tannins, acacia and cassia. Children, see this picture. This is acacia plant. This is cassia plant. The next one is resins. These occur mostly in gymnosperms in specialized passages called resin passages. These are used in varnishes. Resins used in varnishes. The example of pinus. Children, see this picture. This is pinus plant. The next one is gums. Plants like neem, acacia oozes out a sticky substance called gum when branches are cut. The gum swells by absorbing water and helps in the healing of damaging parts of a plant. Students, the gum swells by absorbing water and helps in the healing of damaging parts of a plant. Gums are economically valuable and used as adhesives and binding agents in the preparation of medicines, food, etc. Students, gums are economically valuable and used as adhesives and binding agents in the preparation of medicines, food, etc. Children, see this picture. This is neem plant. This one is acacia plant. The next one is latex. Latex is a sticky and milky white substance secreted by plants. Latex is stored in latex cells or latex vessels. From the latex of Hevea brasiliensis, rubber plant is rubber prepared. From the latex of Hevea brasiliensis, rubber is prepared. Latex from Jatropha is the source of biodiesel. Chewing gum is a type of gum for chewing made dates back 500 years. Modern chewing gum originally made of chicle, natural latex from plant. Whenever pollen grain enter in our body, they cause allergy due to these presence of nitrogenous substances. Whenever pollen grain enters in our body, they cause allergy due to these presences of nitrogenous substances. These allergens cause skin allergy and asthma. These allergens cause skin allergy and asthma. The example of Pardenium. Now discuss about excretion versus secretion. Excretion and secretion are the same in nature. Excretion and secretion are the same in nature. Since both are involved in passage or movement of materials, both process move and eliminate unwanted components from the body. Students, now discuss about differences between excretion and secretion. This one excretion, this one secretion. The process of removing of harmful waste products produced in the body during the process of metabolism. The process of sending, eliminating the unwanted materials from the body. It is passive in nature. It is active in nature. The excretory organs of the humans include lungs, kidneys, skin, gallbladder, urinary bladder, ureters, etc. The excretory organs of the humans include lungs, kidneys, skin, gallbladder, urinary bladder, ureters, etc. The secretory organs of the humans include pituitary glands, thyroid glands, parathyroid glands, adrenal glands, etc. The secretory organs of the humans include pituitary glands, thyroid glands, parathyroid glands, and adrenal glands, etc. The excretory materials are tears, sweat, urine. The secretory materials are saliva and hormones. Okay, students, we discuss more topics in this class. Let us recall once again. Other pathways of excretion, excretion in other organisms, excretion and release of substance in plants, excretion versus secretion. Okay, students, read and learn the above topics. Students, in this topics, session is completed. Children, this session is completed. Take your notebook and write down assignments. The first one is, how are waste products excreted in amoeba? The second one is differences between primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. Write about the accessory excretory organs and their excretory substances in human beings. Fourth one is write the differences between excretion and secretion. And fifth one is collect the uses of different kinds of alkaloids. Take help of library or internet. Okay, students. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.